Good morning, students. Today's topic is Women Empowerment. This topic's objectives are to find out the exact need of women empowerment in India and to assess the awareness of women empowerment in India, to analyze the barriers of women empowerment in India, to examine the nature of women's self-help groups in Haryana, and to examine the challenges impending self-help groups in empowering women in Haryana, and to identify strategies of empowering women through self-help groups. These are the objectives of this topic, and the topic are: what is women empowerment? It refers to increasing the spiritual, political, social, or economic strength of women. It often involves the empowered developing confidence in their own capacities. And the next is the women's empowerment can be defined to promoting women's sense of self-worth, their ability to determine their own choices, and their right to influence social change of themselves and others. And it is closely aligned with female empowerment, a fundamental human right that's also key to achieving a more peaceful, prosperous world. And in Western countries, female empowerment is often associated with specific phases of the women's rights movement in history. This movement tends to be split into three waves. The first beginning in the 19th and early 20th century, where suffrage was a key feature. And the second wave of the 1960s, including the sexual revolution and the role of women in society. Third wave, feminism is often seen as beginning in the 1990s, and women's empowerment and promoting women's rights have emerged as a part of a major global movement and is continuing to break new ground in recent years. Days like International Women's Empowerment Day are also gaining momentum. But despite a great deal of progress, women and girls continue to face discrimination and violence in every part of the world. And this, the global landscape of women's empowerment. gender equity and is the basic human right, and it is also fundamental to having a peaceful, prosperous world. But girls and women continue to face significant challenges all around the world. Women are typically underrepresented in power and decision-making roles. They receive unequal pay for equal work, and they often face legal and other barriers that affect their opportunities to work. And the global landscape, in the developing world, girls and women are often seen as less valuable than boys, instead of being sent to school. They are often made to do domestic work and home, or are married off for a dowry before they are adults. As many as 12 million underage girls are married every year. While some progress is being made in various parts of the world, there is still a great deal left to be done to right the problem of gender inequality. Gender inequality are also the problem of the gender women's, and we need empowerment. This is the main question in our mind. We need empowerment. Why? These are the points of women empowerment needs. Every points we will discuss now. First is educational problems. Women education in India has a major preoccupation of both the government and civil society, as educated women can play a very important role in the development of the country. Education is a milestone of women empowerment because it enables them to respond to the challenges, to comfort their traditional role, and change their life, so that we cannot neglect the importance of education in reference to women empowerment. And India poised to becoming superpower in recent years. Education of women is the most powerful tool to change the position in society. The women education in India has been a need of the hour, as education is a foundation stone for the empowerment of women. Education also brings a reduction in inequalities and functions as a means of empowering their status within the family and develops the concept of participation. And the next is in the society, and the next is gender prejudice, the women inequalities in power sharing and activity, active participation in decision making, including decision making in political process at all level will be ensured for the achievement of the goals of empowerment. All measures will be taken to guarantee women equal access to and full participation in decision-making bodies at every level, including the legislative, executive, judicial, corporate, statutory bodies, as also the advisory commissions, committees, boards, trust, etc. Affirmative action such as reverse reservations, quotas, including in higher legislative bodies, will be considered whenever necessary on a time-bound basis, women-friendly personal policies will also be drawn up to encourage women to participate effectively in the developmental process. And the next point is low confidence. In the society, most women often struggle with self-confidence, and they might hesitate to speak up in meetings, fearing that her contributions will be more closely scrutinized than those of her male counterparts. Or she might even refrain from applying for promotions because of a lack of faith in her qualifications. Consequently, her low self-confidence can hinder them from reaching their full potential professionally. A defect of confidence can inhibit not just their career performance and future, but also their income. In recent survey by international staffing firm Robert Deer, the women's low confidence is the very need in empowerment of women, and the revealed that 68% of men negotiated for a higher salary in 2018 versus just 45% of women. Although over time more and more professionals have proactively sought an increase in salary, women have historically been less likely to do so. Silencing self-doubt and embarrassing self-confidence are key to a truly successful career. And the next point is lack of unity. India's ways, customs and traditions regarding gender have not evolved at the same pace as they have in other countries. However, some are willing to fight for women's empowerment in India. Such a fight has been started by women's rights organization like Safety and Women's on Wings by creating awareness, providing more job opportunity for women, offering self-defense classes, and more women are learning how to stand up for their own rights. And the next need of empowerment, problem related with health. The International Council on Women's Health Issues is an international non-profit association dedicated to the goal of promoting health, healthcare, and well-being of women and girls throughout the world. Through participation, empowerment, advocacy, education, and research, we are a multidisciplinary network of women's health providers, planners, and advocates from all over the globe. We constitute an international professional and lay network of those committed to improving women and girls' health and quality of life. This document provides a description of our organization, mission, vision, and committed to improving the health and well-being of women and girls globally. And the next point is poverty and ignorance. The poverty and ignorance, on the one hand, for some, poverty and disempowerment go hand in hand as income poverty goes down. So do women become more empowered? Development interventions which focus on practical gender needs, including women's income and material assets, will therefore lead both to reduced poverty and to increased female empowerment. Microcredit and women's saving groups are examples of interventions which, through a focus on practical gender needs, aim both to reduce income poverty and contribute to women's empowerment. These are the needs. And the last point of need empowerment the traditional barriers. Traditional barriers is needed. The empowerment. The barriers are, there are many barriers for women to overcome before they can get into leadership positions. The role that individuals, managers, males as well as females, colleges play should be well defined and earnestly implemented to help women to bridge the gender leadership gap and to reap the benefits of diverse leadership team. Women should have support group of peers so as to create safe identity, workplace. Also, men and women should be educated regarding the second generation gender bias so as to help women internalize the leadership identity within themselves. Also, educating women about various barriers to leadership will help them make informal choices in their path of professional achievement. Adding another dimensions, people to today should be aware of the fact that today women represent the majority of higher education graduates, and hence they cannot be undermined. Most importantly, everyone should be aware of the tremendous potential that they have, which can bring out positive result in any organization. So we need empowerment, and the principles of women empowerment. The four principles are to establish high level corporate leadership for gender equality. Treat all women and men fairly at work. Respect and support human rights and non-discrimination. Ensure the health, safety, and well-being of all women and men workers. And next, the promote education, training, and professional development for women. Implement enterprise development, supply chain, and marketing practices that empower women. And next principle is promote equality through community initiatives and advocacy. And the last principle, measure and publicly report on progress to achieve gender equality. These are the principle of women poverty empowerment and government steps. Government steps since independence efforts have been made to educate women on various political, economical, and social issues. And they have made various law in Constitution of India. There are many NGOs running an organization for welfare of women. Government is making efforts for upliftment of women, and they are trying to eradicate and remove problems which women are facing from past. And the problem faced by women have been always under shadow against men. During past years, women were just used a toy to give birth to a child. Women were not given respect, education, and importance. Sati, child, marriage, literacy. And the legislative efforts, the indecent respiration, Representation of Women Act 1886, the Dowry Prohibition Act 1961, the Commission of Sati Act 1987, National Commission for Women Act 1990, Protection for Domestic Violence Bill 2002, Sexual Harassment of Women at Workplace and Other Institutions Supreme Court Order. And the next is, why is empowering girls and women so important? This is the question, importance of women empowerment. Women are leaders everywhere you look. A CEO to housewife that holds together a home. Our country was built by women who stand alone. Empowered women can exert power to shape their families, communities, and countries. And the woman should be respected as well as her needs and aspirations, as she can only give best to society. In the importance, empowering women is essential to the health and social development of family, communities, and countries. When women are living safe, fulfilled, the productive lives, they can reach their full potential, contributing their skills to the workforce, and can raise happier and healthier children. They are also able to help fuel sustainable economies and benefits societies and humanity at large. A key part of this empowerment is through education. Girls who are educated can pursue meaningful work and contribute to the country's economy. Later in life, they are also four times less likely to get married young when they have 8 years of education, meaning that they and their families are healthier. And the next is the benefits of society by women empowerment. Personal knowledge, self-defining, personal power, authenticity, and creativity, physical strength, maturity in relationships, economic independence, and having political power in society. And the next is proportion of women in different sectors. 68.5% women working in farming and 10.8% in manufacturing tobacco products and 5.1% in construction work and 3.8% in educational work and 2.1% work in grocery stores and 1.6% in household work, 1.5% in personal services, and 1.1% in healthcare work, and 1% in bureaucracy. These are the proportion of women in different sectors. And great women personalities, Mother Teresa, she was a social worker and she helped many women and changed their life. And next, Indira Gandhi, she was first woman Prime Minister of India. And the next is Kalpana Chawla, first woman of Indian origin to go in space. And the next is Kiran Bedi. Kiran Bedi, India's first lady IPS officer. And next, the Vijay Lakshmi Pandit, first woman president of UN General Assembly. And the next is Pratibha Patil, first woman president of India. These are the personality of India. And the next, the real stories of women's empowerment. Marriage, one last chance. When 14-year-old Mary started school, there were equal numbers boys and girls, but in her year 8 class, she is the only girl surrounded by 19 boys. I want to finish secondary school too and want to prove that girls cannot do it, Mary says with a look to determination. And this is the school and The Mary is there, and there is the class. And Tabitha baking to give back, and smells of fresh bread. Voices to Lily's talking, a faint glow flickers through the windows. And there, the day's baking has begun. Her at the Thasing Mokali Bakery in Lesotho. Tabitha is one of the bakery's two senior group members, a local posture. She had seen the challenges that faced people in her community, and she was particularly concerned by the limited opportunities for young people. And if Mary graduates primary school, she will be the first girl in her family with the certificate. In South Sudan, girls who complete all their education are exceptional due to the conflict and poverty. Only 30% of the children who are of a school-going age are currently studying. Gender inequality is also a factor, and only one in every seven girls, 18%, finish primary school in South Sudan. But World Vision is acting to support education in Mary's communities. We built the primary school that Mary attends and provides teachers with financial incentives and materials to work there. The 2,700 children currently enrolled in the school are provided with school supplies, books, uniforms, pens, and pencils. We are addressing gender inequality in education through community awareness seasons with parents, but changing behavior and customs that have lasted for generations requires persistence and determination. Say Gold Fairy, a World Vision project manager working in Mary's community. Mary hopes that one day she can change her community, and that through her example, more girls will be able to continue studying. Until then, she will continue to keep taking notes and writing tests towards her goal of finishing her education. This is the story of Mary and the next Tabitha waking to get back, and the how can I empower women and girl standing with the investing in women is an important start. And from workplaces and schools to homes and communities, women gender equality underpins all of world visions work, and there are many great activities you can get involved in to support the rights of women in developing country. And she began to ask herself how she could help her community, and even naturally, the bakery was born. Alongside another grandmother named Malhaka Mesta, the Bithyan began baking bread to create empowerment opportunities. With the help of World Vision, the duo were given a baking oven and other critical equipment. This means they were able to move from the inefficient process of breaking in the earth dug fire pit, and instead could bake indoors. This also means they were able to expand and attract new team members. And the empowerment of women and girls is the form for the women like Tabitha having a livelihood like this is a path of hope. In many parts of the world, women are not equipped with the skills, knowledge, and access to funding that allows them to start working and take control of their futures. And the next is how World Vision is helping empower women. We believe that healthy, educated, and empowered women and girls are agents for change. When women and girls are supported, they gain opportunities to speak up for their rights. And sponsorship, this means women organizations, women's empowerment policies, and women's charities can gain momentum and contribute to a strong world. In our sponsorship program, when you sponsor a girl, you not only help give a girl opportunity she may have been denied, but our community focused approach means that her whole community benefits too. helping girls and women learn advocacy skills at all stages of life so that can use their voices effectively for their own rights, attending with communities, faith leaders and governments to challenge and correct harmful social norms that keep women and girls from their potential. Rising awareness around the causes of poor health and well-being that are related to gender. And empowering women and girls through water, sanitation, and hygiene, health, and nutrition. Livelihoods, training, and education programs to increase their opportunities and ability to reach their full potential. This is the mean of women's and the organizations, women's empowerment policies, women's charities, and can gain momentum and contribute to a strong world. This is the topic of women empowerment. At the end of this topic, references there. These are the references of this topic. And at the end of the topic, some MCQs questions is there. First question, name the online platform launched by the Ministry of Women and Child Development to support women entrepreneurship, Digital India, Mahila E-Hat, One Stop Center Scheme, and none of the above. The answer of this question is Mahila E-Hat is the online platform launched by the Ministry of Women and Child Development to support women entrepreneurship. And the next question, the Central Social Welfare Board was established in 1950, 1951, 1952, and 1953. What is the answer? The answer is 1953 is the right answer of this question. And the next question, Women Helpline Scheme was launched in 2012, 2015, 2017, and 2018. The Women Helpline Scheme was launched in 2015. This is the right answer of this question. And the next question, which of the following scheme provided education to girls and their welfare? One Stop Center Scheme, Ujjwala, Swadhar Scheme, Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. The right option is this question is Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao is the right answer of this question. And next question is, which scheme help in the prevention of trafficking and provide support for rescue, rehabilitation, reintegration, and repartitions of women? Ujjwala scheme, STAP scheme, Priyadarshini scheme, and DWCRA scheme. The right answer is Ujjwala scheme is the right answer of this question. And the next question, support to training and employment program for women scheme is Swadhar, STAP, Nari Shakti, Purushkar, and RMK scheme. The right answer of this question is STAP scheme is the right answer of this question. And the next question, Priyadarshini scheme provides women empowerment, livelihood and mid genetic plan, empower to address women legal, political and health problems, and all the above are correct. The right answer of this question is all the above are correct, is the right answer of this question. And the next question is Indira Gandhi Mativa Sahyog Yojana was launched in 2008, 2010, 2012 and 2015. The right answer of this question is 2010 is the right answer of this question. And next question is National Mission for Empowerment of Women was launched on 15th August 2010, 15th August 2011, 15 October 2010, 15 October 2011. The right answer of this question is 15th August 2011 is the right answer. And the next question and last question of this topic, which scheme promotes community participation through involvement of students, volunteers for empowerment of rural women? The option is Nand Ghar Yojana, Eswamth Portal, Pradhan Mantri Mahila Shakti Kendra Scheme, and Shebox portal. The right answer of this question is Pradhan Mantri Mahila Shakti Kendra scheme is the right answer of this question. This is the all about of the topic women empowerment, and the end of this topic. Thank you. Mm-hmm.